10 ways to improve your city roads in pure vanilla Minecraft with no mods, no texture packs, no fancy world edit tricks. In this video, I'm going to show you 10 things that you can do to really amp up your roads and make them rock. Whether you're playing Pocket Edition, Xbox or PS4, or Java Edition, these are things that anybody can do with just the basic game. Let's get started. Number 10. Turn lanes. These add a nice touch of realism. However, you do need to plan ahead because you will need your roads to be wide enough to add this extra lane. Another nice detail to add, turn arrows. Adds that nice finishing touch. Number 9. Intersections. There's a lot that I can say about intersections, but the main thing I want to touch on here is crosswalks. So, there are a couple different styles here that I've come up with. Basically, just the regular hash marks here. You can have a solid kind of a rectangle box kind of thing on this one. And over here is a combination of the two. Doesn't necessarily matter what type you use. All have been used realistically in IRL. But they should be in white. So every crosswalk that I've ever seen has been painted white. So that is the color that is preferred. Number 8, sidewalk decor. Don't leave them boring. Add some bushes, some shrubs, some trees, some grass, some flowers, a little water feature maybe. And this is a nice little detail, little drop down here for access for wheelchairs and baby strollers and such. Number 7, sidewalk details. Other than landscaping, add some side street parking, add some parking meters, add some bus stops. Gotta have that public transportation. Another nice detail is obviously water features where you can add fountains. Those are pretty common. However, something not so common, add some artistic sculptures. Maybe combine those with a water feature to have a water featured sculpture. Something unique, something different, something that will really make your city stand out. Number 6. Using iron trap doors, you can make some sewer drain covers. You can make some curbside drains, add a little bit of realism, and you can hide some lighting down there too, so you can have some extra lighting along your streets. Number 5, traffic lights. Easily done with banners. You can make whatever kind of support structure that you want. This is just what I've come up with. These banners are not my design. They've been around for however long. So you can easily find this banner pattern design on the internet. Actually, I'll try and remember to leave a link down in the description below for you. Another thing, pay attention to the traffic flow direction. You don't want those traffic lights hanging over on this side because nobody's going to see them. So you want to make sure that your traffic lights are in the proper traffic flow direction. Number 4, road signs. These can be relatively easily done with using maps. This is just a map that I've created. I say relatively easily because, you know, maps take a heck of a long time because they're really huge. But you can make any kind of sign that you want, and they can be totally reusable. You don't have to worry about recreating them. You can just keep using them over and over again. So here I've got a stop sign, and here we have a speed limit sign. Of course, you will probably need to create several of these for the different speed limits for different types of roads. Just a quick tip on the map making thing. There's several things that you can do to kind of make things easier on yourself. You can teleport 10,000 blocks away, create an area for all your maps, and then just kind of teleport back and forth. You can, of course, use World Edit to copy and paste. And another alternative that I use is a mod called Lightmatica. What I do is I create all my maps in a separate single-player world, a flat world, and just copy and paste using Lightmatica into this world, and then I just delete the map from this world once I've created the map, and I store all the maps in a chest over in the bank. I don't know, just something weird I do. But a quick thing on Lightmatica. It is a great alternative to using World Edit. I myself am not totally familiar with World Edit. I seem to have to look everything up whenever I want to do something. And just using Lightmatica is just quicker and easier for me. It's great for doing the map thing, but it's also great for any kind of builds that you have in your city, you want to move something or you want to add to it, or, you know, whatever you need to do, it is a really cool alternative to using World Edit. It's also great for doing repetitive things like adding your streetlights or extending roads, adding the dash lines, or anything that's repetitive that you want to add a bunch of the same thing to. Lightmatica makes it real super easy to do. And there might be a beginner's guide tutorial coming up soon on the channel for using Lightmatica, so wink, wink, nudge, nudge. Keep an eye out for that. Here I've got a city directional sign. I really don't even know what the technical term is for these, but, you know, it's just a road sign that lets you know which way the beach is, or which way whatever is. I don't know. Road signs, use them. Number three, medians. This is another pre-planning kind of thing, so you want to make your roads wide enough so that you do have some space for a median, and don't just leave them boring. Add some gravel, add some stone in there, add some coarse dirt, some bushes, some trees, some grass, some flowers. Add your streetlights in there as well. Just something to kind of keep the detail thing going and keep things interesting. Number two, parking lots. While not technically a road, it is part of the road complex, and I'm going to include it here in this video. You want to make sure that your spacing is nice and correct. You want to make sure you add some disabled parking spaces. You want to add some details for no parking areas where this yellow is, here and here. And again, like in this parking lot here, you want to make sure that you have enough spacing around the stalls so that cars can still drive in and out. And the number one way to improve your city roads, proper painted lines. There are colors that need to go in certain places, typically white and yellow. And now here in the United States, white is typically on the inside, so next to the sidewalk. Yellow is in the center next to the median, which separates the directional flow of traffic. It varies from road to road depending on the type of road, the highways, the small city streets, the small suburb streets. They're all kind of different, but the colors pretty much remain the same, just the placement is a little bit different. You want to pay attention to your lane dashes, the separators for the lanes. Try and stick with a common layout. You know, whatever the case you choose, just try and stay consistent so that everything looks and stays consistent throughout the city. You want to make sure that your crosswalks are the proper color. I think I mentioned earlier that they should be in white. You want to have stop lines. Stop lines are typically just before the crosswalk. And just like over on this one here, there would be a stop line here for the traffic light. There would also be stop lines for a stop sign. You could also include bike lanes. I have not actually done that. It's just something I just kind of thought about lately. I didn't plan for that initially, so that's something that you might want to plan for. Make sure your roads are wide enough. I would suggest maybe a 2, maybe a 3 block spacing for a bike lane. I think 2 would probably be enough. But the most important thing is consistency with your lines. Not all streets actually have the lines. Some small suburb streets not going to have the lines, like in a housing tract. They're not going to be any lines there. There might be some stop lines, but there wouldn't be actual like painted lines down the sides or through the middle. Best thing to do, I would suggest, for getting a good idea of what colors and how the lines are painted on the roads, is not just by driving around and kind of observing what the lines look like in your part of the world, but to Google search. You can Google search city painted lines or city roads line, you know, something along those search terms, and that will give you a whole bunch of stuff. Or city planning, something along those lines will give you all kinds of information, get you going on the right track. But those definitely make the biggest difference for your city roads. So there you have it, 10 ways to improve your city roads. I hope you've enjoyed the video. I hope you learned something. I hope I'm able to inspire you with some ideas by showing you kind of this little part of my city. And you might be wondering why my skin looks like this. It is the month of October, and throughout the month of October, I will be wearing my Friday the 13th Halloween costume. Scary, scary. Thank you so much for watching. please do me a big favor. I would really appreciate it. Hit that like button for me. Scroll just a little to the right, that big red subscribe. Hit that one too. I'm going to be doing more videos like this, help you guys out with your cities, and hopefully I will see you down in the Crafter Sub Club. I'm out of here. See you next time. Whoa, 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 whoa. Where are you going? I got awesome over here on the left. I got more awesome over here on the right. And for all the awesome, click that subscribe button. Thanks for watching. See you next time.